and one up there.
You get the tall one.
Okay, so we got that fixed. All right. Now shut the... Okay, so let's not shut the door yet. Let me get this window down.
Yeah.
All right, now go ahead. Oh my God, look at it. It looks great. Thanks, guy.
Time for a drive.
It is.
Do me a favor before you get out. I want you to reverse a little bit to my direction. I want to see the back reverse light.
Put on a blinker.
Those lights make a big difference.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so now you've seen how the Freedom Flyer flag looks on the back of the Jeep. My bro here, Sean, taking the Jeep out, letting it flutter around, showing how much we love America. What do you think, man? You like it? You like it, Jenna? What about you, Justin?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, it is cool. All right, good.
There, it's close enough.
Buckets.
Buckets!
Okay.
Ooh, nice shot.
The kids did a really good job helping me. So Justin did a really good job. That tire was a big mess to take off and put back on. Jenna did a good job too. So.
Nah, she was just there for like company.
That's okay. Kids did really good. So now they know how to work on a Jeep.
You've been out here for a while cleaning. Oh, it smells good too. Mmm.
I hope.
Yeah.
Hey.
What do you think of that?
I smell better than the lotion.
Better than your lotion. I know. It's killing me, man. Oh, it's awful.
Too strong?
Yeah, this is like 25 old ladies by me. Now he's upgraded. What are we going to do now? We're going to do the flagpole installation.
Yep.
All right. I can do that as long as they stay in their lane.
I think homeschool is the way to go. That guy up there doesn't even have his lights on. That truck up there?
Yeah.
If you did homeschool, Fred, I don't think you'd really be homeschooling at all. Because you'd want to just be
out
with Fred.
Sure.
So, it wouldn't be
tomorrow's our big trip to St. Louis, Missouri to Six Flags, and I'm looking forward to some roller coaster rides. I know these two aren't real thrilled about it. I know they hate Six Flags.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You're funny.
Yeah. They're like, Six Flags? I don't want to go to Six Flags. All right. Guess we don't have to go to Six Flags. Wonder if they'll ever add a flag and call it Seven Flags or 10 Flags.
I don't know.
I mean,
change it to
change it up a little bit.
Change his name, like IHOP, went from IHOP to IHOB.
Well, you know what IHOP stands for, right?
International House of Pancakes.
Yep. IHOP, you hop, we all hop to the IHOP. How's that? That's pretty clever, wasn't it?
Send it in, you might be a slogan for them.
Okay. Maybe I can get some free pancakes. But I don't like waffles, and I don't want any fruit on my pancakes. Would you have like a whole like blob of strawberries on your pancakes and just call it a day?
No.
No, I wouldn't either.
I like my pancakes with syrup.
I like syrup and butter, yep, that's right.
look at that sunset. It's just so awesome.
It's usually like that.
See, we don't have fun things like this in Minnesota, not too often anymore. This is about to look at that down there.
You see the shadow up there?
Yeah.
Like teasing.
Yeah.
It's just like maybe a couple drops, not like really rain. Maybe though, I don't know. Looks like the road's wet.
So about what time? So we'll get there about 11, and then what time will we leave?
Don't know. What time we're leaving? Why don't we just not worry about that? Let's just worry about getting there. When everyone's tired, once you get home, then we'll leave. That's the better way of looking at it. Let's keep our fingers crossed that it's not going to rain tomorrow. So we'll keep an eye on the weather. If it looks like it's going to rain, then I don't see a point in going if it's going to rain. You know what I mean? Then we can go Thursday or something.
I thought that's when we were going to Clinton.
Well, I think you know where you're going because I don't.
I do this every day because I take a longer route.
Really?
Yeah.
How long does it take you to get home then from school? Like an hour?
not too long.
You're just trying to get some drive time in before you have to settle in at home. Isn't it nice having the freedom of a car and just get in and just go?
Yeah, when I ask mom first.
Well, in 3 years you won't have to. You'll be out on your own.
It won't even be three. It's two.
Or two, yeah. But you think you're going to leave like the day after you graduate?
As soon as I can leave, I'm gone.
Really?
Yep.
You're not going to look back? You're just going
to... Not at this place, no.
Just parked by the truck, by a Keith's truck? Because I'm going to grab my bag and then head back. Head to the motel. So hold up your big check. Who's it by? Who paid it?
My owner of the hotel theater.
So
So what are you going to do tomorrow? Are you going to deposit it, or are you going to just frame that, and that'll be your frame?
We need that. We needed it with you.
Now send that to my phone, because like I said, when Worth is all sitting here, showing the camera in his face.
Where's your rope? That's your rope?
I made my own picture.
There you go.
We had a great time with the Freedom Flyer pole on the back tire here on the Jeep, but unfortunately it's time to take it off. So I got some helpers here on this super hot day here in Illinois, in Paris. What do you think, guys? It's pretty hot out here, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So, would you rather do this or go swimming?
Swim.
Okay. So, are you going to help me, or you want to go swimming after you help me?
Swim after
you help me, because either way we're helping you.
Okay. So, it's only going to take a short time to do it. Justin and Jenna are really smart on how to take the straps off.
So, you push this in.
Where it says release.
You pull it back.
Pull back.
And you're still pushing in it, and then you pull this back.
So you're keeping the release button down as you pull the straps out?
Yes.
Okay, good.
All right, so go ahead and lift it off and out. And now we got the Freedom Flyer off the Jeep now. So what we're gonna do here is disassemble the flagpole from the main part here that goes on the tire.
It's there.
So we need to get our tools. So why don't you look inside the Jeep there and grab our tools.
Pull that up, see if you see 7/16. Right here. Let's pull that up. So we're just going to go ahead and loosen this up.
Sorry, I had to find my key.
All right, take this nut.
So we don't need this anymore?
We're going to take...
Which way?
That way. Yep. Perfect.
I think the pole can... that's the only thing that's keeping the pole on now.
Yep, I got it. Perfect.
You got it?
Okay.
I'm going to have to take Justin with me to Minnesota so he can help me put this thing on and off the tire. What do you think?
I want to come.
All right.
I'll come with you.
Okay.
We got the pole off. Now, there's another part of this pole, which is this part here. So there's two poles in one. And this gives us our height on the flagpole that we want. Is that warning sign on here? Here's the warning sign that's on there telling you that if you're driving, you don't want this warning sticker to show.
Well, no, I don't remember.
There we go. Just like this. Ruby.